first and foremost, I want to say to every one of you that pro or con, and I think I speak for virtually all of my colleagues, we want to hear from you. You know, you have to stop and think. I can't remember a time when the St. Louis County prosecutor took a case, investigated a case, and prosecuted a case against a city council member for assault on someone they represent. Whether we agree or we disagree, Mr. Glickert was convicted by a jury of his peers for misdemeanor assault. As most people know, I'm clearly know now, the victim is a resident of the Second Ward, a school teacher, a parent. And this meeting occurred at a public University City meeting. It is fair to say that I've heard from many of you, and I've taken the time to read some of the posts on social media. But again, we all want to hear from you. The council has many options available to it. I, for one, want to give Mr. Glickert the opportunity and some time to determine what he thinks is in the best interest of our community. I applaud his apology, but I believe that is just. But again, needless to say, this body has been in this position three times before in the most recent past. Several years ago, Mr. Glickert and Ms. Wells sought and were successful in censoring Byron Price for doing nothing more than rising from his seat in a menacing fashion. He was censored for rising from his seat. Then Mr. Glickert, Mr. Jennings, and Ms. Wells sat on their hands and never chose to do anything when former Councilmember Crow both issued an obscenity towards a citizen and threw a water bottle during a discussion with the citizen. They sat silently and said nothing needed to be done. Then, of course, we really do have the more amazing one where Mr. Glickert, Ms. Welsh, and Mr. Jennings sought to have me removed from office for sharing an email that everybody was heard by, I think, has seen and could have seen when it was shared. They had to settle for a censure. In all three instances, Mr. Glickert and Ms. Welsh ignored the voices in the audience. In all three instances, the overwhelming number of people who came to those meetings said, do not do this. Or in Dr. Kraft's case, please do something. To all the people who came out and spoke, you had enough care and concern to speak, but your voices were not heard. In the most recent event, the famous quote, which will now probably follow me the rest of my life, what an odd phrase to have attached to your name, the mayor, with no authority, went out and got special counsel. And by the way, if anyone would like to see that entire file, the council has now voted to make that entire file public. And I would ask anyone who wants to know more about it to please go ahead and do so. But let's distinguish those cases from this one. In this case, an independent prosecutor chose to address the situation. An independent judge conducted a trial. An independent jury issued a unanimous verdict of guilty in 1 hour. I would like to follow what Ms. Hummel said. You owe it to yourselves to view the tapes. I also applaud Mr. McMahon for wanting to make the transcripts public, because there should not be any secrecy here. This is a process, and it is going to be a public process. And there is no need to move quickly with this, because we want you to have the time to see the information, and we want you to have the time to get with us. We have several options available to us. If Mr. Glickert chooses to take no action himself, but I do hope that is not the case. I also want to say that though I do welcome his apology, he has had well over a year to apologize for this event and to make amends for his conduct. Finally, as someone who's been involved in, I think, a lot of minority rights movements, I continue to be disheartened by the number of people who have the mantra, let's go blame the victim. If you get a chance, please, please read the transcript of this case. This has been the mantra of many members of this council to always blame the victim. This was part of the defense strategy. It didn't work with the jury, and it's not going to work with our community. We deserve better than this, but particularly for those of you sitting in this room who are in the minorities, when someone blames you for the action taken against you, that is wrong. And we, as a community, deserve better. I also believe clearly that it is disingenuous for anyone now to say that they were threatened, even though they were in a room full of uniformed police officers. They were threatened, but they didn't go to police officers. They went to someone else. That doesn't sound to me like being threatened. That sounds to me like evening the score or trying to do something else. So once again, to our citizens, you deserve better than this. Finally, to our new police chief, I hope that the police department has reviewed the tapes, because I clearly believe that they are a teachable moment. In reviewing the tapes myself, I am saddened at the blatantly preferential treatment that was shown to an elected official who was clearly in the wrong versus a citizen. To the police, I understand in reviewing the tapes that you were in a lose-lose situation. If you look at the tapes, you will be shown the good old boy hugging and smiling that to any citizen has to cause you some pause, because that simply is not right. While I hope that everyone is treated with respect, council members do not deserve the preferential treatment that was exhibited that night versus a citizen. So, I'd like to thank Mr. Hales for using his time well and using the statement that I have used as well. When Ms. Welch sanctioned someone for rising from their seat, she said his actions were not worthy of the citizens of this community. So what should we expect this time? I mean, really, we censured somebody when he leaned forward in the chair over there. He got censured. So I look to the mayor for leadership on this, because the standard needs to apply to all of us. So I do hope in the coming week that Mr. Glickert and Ms. Welch will put the interests of our community ahead of their own and come to a conclusion before council comes to its own. Thank you.